American Top 40.
At number 12 in the countdown in American Top 40 is a Texas-born singer and musician who once was a member of the New Christy Minstrels. Then he and two other fellas, Mike Settle and Terry Williams, left the Minstrels and formed the First Edition, where they had 8 chart records. This is his first big solo hit, Kenny Rogers and Lucille.
In a bar in Toledo, across from the depot, you picked a fine time to leave me, Lucille.
Kenny Rogers with a song at number 12 this week in just 4 short weeks. It's a former number 1 country song, Lucille.
American Top 40.
On American Top 40, I'm Charlie Van Dyke sitting in for Casey Kasem this week. Now, we're up to the hit song by a superstar whose singing voice has been earning an income estimated at over $20 million a year. But even if this man were to retire his husky voice tomorrow, he could still make a good living from his second career, starring in movies at $1 million each. I'm talking about the man from Houston, the silver-bearded balladeer, Kenny Rogers. And Kenny has good reason for demanding that kind of money for his movies. His first TV movie, the film version of his song, The Gambler, was a huge hit. And Kenny's latest TV movie, the miniseries called The Gambler 2, turned out to be one of the highest-rated shows of 1983. And by the way, the day after The Gambler 2 aired, Kenny's fans ran out and bought an additional 100,000 Kenny Rogers albums, which means that his appearance in that miniseries earned Kenny a good deal more than the $1 million he was paid for his acting talents. This week, the singer with a real golden touch is at number 23 with his 33rd chart hit, Kenny Rogers and This Woman. Holding at number 23 for a second week, that's Kenny Rogers with This Woman. For Casey, I'm Charlie Van Dyke.
American Top 40.
These are enduring legends and the songs that made them chart champions in the triathlon of rock and roll. We're up to a man now who learned overnight success doesn't always last. Here's Kenny Rogers.
Yeah, I think that the best thing that happened to me was having the ups and downs that I've had going from the First Edition and, you know, being successful with that and then having the down period in there. I think I learned to appreciate really how important good management and proper professional attitude is, and also how to, if and when I ever got this whole thing together again, how to keep it going, hopefully for some length of time anyhow.
At number 13 among chart survivors, here's Kenny singing a 1983 smash duet with Dolly Parton that hit number 1 pop and country, Kenny Rogers, Islands in the Stream. Islands in the Stream, Kenny Rogers and Dolly Parton with that number one song from 1983. One of the many hits spanning 3 decades that places Kenny Rogers at number 13 in the triathlon of rock as we sprint onward toward the number one endurance champ of all.
The hits from coast to coast.